Donald Trump's inner circle may be getting another makeover, and so may some of his policies.
Well, I think we have shaken him up, and I think we've had one of the most successful 13 weeks in the history of presidency.
Chief strategist Steve Bannon is licking his wounds after a public dressing down by the president, who described him to the Wall Street Journal as a guy who works for me. Now Washington's favorite parlor game, parsing the Trump palace intrigue, is kicking into overdrive, as the downfall of one aide appears to be giving rise to a lesser-known face in the West Wing. Gary Cohn serves as Trump's economic council director. The former COO of Goldman Sachs is a registered Democrat, though he's also given money to Republicans, and he's been quietly pushing a more centrist agenda in the halls of the White House. The success of the more moderate faction in the West Wing, which includes Cohn, Trump's son-in-law and senior advisor Jared Kushner, and Deputy National Security Advisor for Strategy Dina Powell, was on clear display this week. The president insisting China is no longer a currency manipulator, abandoning this refrain from the campaign trail.
We are going to label China a currency manipulator, which is what they're doing.
And lavished praise on Federal Reserve Chairwoman Janet Yellen after lampooning her during the campaign.
And in my opinion, Janet Yellen is highly political, and she's not raising rates for a very specific reason, because Obama told her not to.
As the nationalist champions in Trump's White House appear to be losing ground, some internal alliances may be shifting. Policy advisor Stephen Miller, a prominent Trump cheerleader on the campaign trail.
Are you ready to elect a man who can't be bought, who can't be purchased, and who will only answer to the American people?
Found a kindred spirit in Steve Bannon. Now, a senior administration official says Miller has been branching out, working more closely with Jared Kushner's Office of American Innovation and assisting Ivanka Trump in her policy pursuits on paid family leave. As for the president, he ended the week non-committal on whether a staff shakeup is in the works, telling the Wall Street Journal, "From day to day, I don't know."